Hi, I'm Larry Karaszewski, and this is Trailers from Hell. Peter Sellers was a phenomenal actor and comedian, maybe one of the most talented performers of all time. But he often threw away his gifts in absolutely horrible films. His IMDb page could use a few more being theres and a lot less Fu Manchus. The one we're going to look at today is one of his least known and best performances. It's very low-key. It's called Hoffman from 1970.
Do you know the most natural thing in the world? To awaken one morning and find a strange, beautiful girl asleep by your side. My dream. Every man's dream.
Okay, be honest. You've never seen this film. You've never heard of this film. It's one of Peter Sellers' most obscure works. And one of the big reasons for that is because Peter Sellers wanted to destroy the film. He offered to buy back the movie so it wouldn't be released. But not because he thought it was no good, but because he felt it was too honest. It exposed too much of the real Peter Sellers that he had previously hid behind outrageous characters. Thank God he didn't, because I'm actually quite fond of this one. I'm not going to pretend it's some long-lost masterpiece, but it is a compelling and creepy character study. It's based on an acclaimed television play that starred Donald Pleasence, that won lots of awards. The director here, Alvin Rakoff, was also the director of the TV version. Sellers had wanted to dump him, but the studio backed the director. Sellers also originally wanted to play the part with a wacky accent, but the director talked him into playing it more naturally. Sellers, in fact, plays it so low-key that he's sometimes pretty much a blank, much like I've always heard the real Sellers was. Now, it's a bit of a nightmare to think Sellers looked at this as his most personal character because the lead role is a Me Too disaster. Sellers is a boss who blackmails a young female employee into spending a few days in a love nest. It's a fairly unpleasant idea, and of course the plot eventually gets her to be sympathetic towards him. But I will say that the film seems aware of how nasty this is. That's kind of the plot. Sinéad Cusack plays the woman. She's great, a huge theater actress and married in real life to the actor Jeremy Irons. Now, Sellers was an insanely self-destructive actor, a man of extreme talent who seemed to love to drive directors crazy. If you get a chance, see a documentary about the making of a film he did a couple years after Hoffman called Ghost in the Noonday Sun, in which he made director Peter Medak's Life a Living Hell, so much so that that film remained unreleased for a decade. Now, I can't give a huge thumbs up to Hoffman, but I'm a Sellers completist, and the odd ones intrigue me as much as the masterpieces, so if you're at all interested, check it out. If it sounds horrible, then stay away. That's actually a pretty good advice for most things in life.
So be in your seats when the name Hoffman spells out on the film coming to the cinema.
Nothing like I have to do now.
Hoffman, the man who gets his way.
But not the way you think.